Welcome everyone. So students, we will discuss the questions from the rest part of zoology. Okay. So 31st question is, what triggers the activation of prototoxin to active BT toxin of Bacillus thuringiensis in bollworm? Okay. This question is from application of recombinant DNA technology for insecticidal cases. Okay, four options are given: body temperature, moist surface of midgut, alkaline pH of gut, and acidic pH of stomach. So what will be the correct answer? Before solving this question, we have to discuss a little bit things. We know that this BT toxin is called the toxin which is extracted from the strain of Bacillus thuringiensis, and it is used for the insecticidal case for the insect those are causing for the devastation of crop plants, and most of the times it is cotton crops. Okay, so what happens? The use of this BT toxin with the production of new breeds of cotton, it has its proform or protoform. So when the insect is taking the leaf of the cotton, then these protoforms of these toxins become activated to its original form by the pH of the midgut. Okay, by the alkaline pH of the midgut, because in the midgut of insect the pH is quite alkaline. And in that alkaline medium, when this prototoxin become reached, they becomes active. When they becomes active, they just binding to the receptors present on the cells or on the lining of midgut and increase the permeability to enter the cell. When the activated toxins enter the midgut, they helpful for the forming holes or pores throughout these cells, and eventually death of the insect takes place. So this is the reason. This is also a direct question. So answer will be option 3, that is alkaline pH of gut. Okay. So Bacillus thuringiensis form protein crystals during a particular phase of their growth. These crystals contain a toxic insecticidal protein. These proteins exist is an inactive prototoxin form, but once an insect inject the inactive toxin, it is converted into an active form of toxin due to alkaline pH of the gut. So when it becomes active, it solubilizes the crystals. The activated toxins bind the receptor present on the midgut of epithelial cells and create the pores. Okay, this is the easy question. Then next come to question number 32. This question is from 11th NCERT, that is chapter of neural coordination, and it is directly asking from the sense organ. Okay, what is the question? Which of the following statement is correct? Cornea is an external transparent and protective proteinaceous covering of the eyeball. Cornea consists of dense connective tissue of elastin and can repair itself. Cornea is convex, transparent layer which is highly vascularized. Cornea consists of dense matrix of collagen and is the most sensitive portion of the eye. So this answer will be the option 3. Cornea is convex, transparent layer which is highly vascularized. Okay. Again, this cornea, which is actually covers the pupil, which is the anterior opening of the center of the eye, and also the iris through which light get enter to our eye. Okay, so for your description, here is the diagram given, and what we know that the entire human eye is covered by three layers: sclera, choroid, and retina. The sclera layer in anterior position, they becomes a white transparent like cells or tissue layers, that is called cornea, which is the connective tissue. So cornea is transparent and which is highly vascularized. Okay, so this is direct question from NCERT. Next, identify the cells whose secretions protects the lining of GI tract from various enzymes. Four options: chief cells, goblet cells, oxyntic cells, and duodenal cells. Okay, so the answer will be option, this is wrongly given, the answer will be option 1, that is chief cells. The gastric chief cells, also known as zymogenic cells or peptic cells, is the cells in the stomach that releases pepsinogen and chymosin. Pepsinogen is activated into digestive enzyme pepsin when it comes in contact with acids and produced by gastric parietal cells. Okay, because what happens actually, different enzymes are becomes because the pH of the GI tract is so much varied. Sometimes it becomes very acidic. Sometimes it becomes so much alkaline. Okay, so to protect the enzymes, the chief cells secretes mucus lines, which protects the lines. Then what is the function of goblet cells? Goblet cells secretes mucus and bicarbonates present in the gastric juice, which plays an important role in lubrication and protection of mucosal epithelium from the excretion of highly concentrated hydrochloric acid. Then parietal cells. Parietal cells are also called oxyntic cells. They are present in the stomach epithelium cells and which secret gastric acid. So parietal cells secretes gastric acid. Okay, and that is hydrochloric acid. So the hydrochloric acid, which is the main key molecule of our stomach, which is secreted by parietal cells, also called oxyntic cells. This year also maybe question will be asked from this section. So you have to remember line by line from the NCERT. Then duodenal cells also secretes mucus layers. Next question, extrusion of second polar body from egg nucleus occurs. This is again the direct question from human reproduction part, and this is directly from oogenesis. Okay. So the question is asking about extrusion of second polar body. So what we learned in oogenesis, that there are two polar body becomes arised. So first we have to analyze the event what actually going on. So this diagram is given to you. Oogenesis, when the germinal epithelium, the starting of the oogenesis takes place, the germinal epithelium contains oogonium, that is egg mother cells, which is a diploid. So that undergoes repeated mitosis to form primary oocyte, which is also diploid. Then what happens in meiosis 1? In meiosis 1, a secondary oocyte will be produced, that is haploid, and the first polar body will be produced. This first polar body may be redivided or it may be degraded. If it will be redivided, then it will also be degraded. Okay, the future or the fate of this first polar body will be must be degraded. Then what will be valuable? Valuable will be secondary oocyte. Again, that secondary oocytes, when undergoes meiosis 2, so students mark carefully, under meiosis 2 it is given if fertilization occurs, okay, prior to the entry of the sperm into the ova or ovum cell or secondary oocyte, then only the signaling will be going on, and then only the last phase of the separation of secondary oocyte will be takes place, then egg will be produced and second polar body will be produced. So where is the second polar body will be produced? Now prior to the entry of sperm cells, or if fertilization takes place, then only ovum and second polar body will be produced. So what will be our answer? What are different options given? After the entry of sperm, but before fertilization, after fertilization, before entry of sperm into ovum, simultaneously with the first cleavage. So answer will be number one, after the entry of sperm but before fertilization. We know that fertilization is the aggregation of different two male and female pronuclei, but it is saying before fertilization, just when the sperm just reached in the periphery of ovum, then signaling will be going on. So this is produced with the help of prior to sperm entry, and second polar body will be produced. This is also a direct question from NCERT. Then come to identify the correct representing and causative agent of typhoid fever and the confirmatory test for typhoid. This is from Human Health and Disease. That is, the first option is Plasmodium vivax UTI test, Streptococcus pneumoniae Widal test, Salmonella typhi Anthrone test, and again Salmonella typhi Widal test. We know that Salmonella typhi, which bacterium is causes typhoid, and the confirmatory test for Salmonella typhi is Widal test. Okay, so what are different extra for pneumonia? That will be X-ray for amoebiasis, that is CIE and ELISA, and for cancer it is X-ray and CT scan.
सो यू हैव टू चूज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. सो फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 35 करेक्ट ऑप्शन विल बी ऑप्शन 4 दैट इज सैल्मोनेला टाइफी व्हिच इज कन्फर्म्ड बाय द बायोकेमिकल टेस्ट दैट इज विडा.